Why would methylated vitamins increase central sensitization to pain?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Heather Chandler says, are you aware of any mechanism by which methylated vitamins, such as methylfolate and methylcobalamin, could increase pain in the form of central sensitization? Increasing BDNF, TNF-alpha, and VEGF, vascular endothelial growth factor, are well-established ways to increase central sensitization, but I'm not sure if methylated vitamins have any relation to those. So first of all, my general default position, if people have problems with methylated vitamins that they don't have from other vitamins, is that their methylation system is kind of unstable and it needs to be stabilized. And so my first thoughts, without getting into specifics on mechanisms or symptoms, is that for someone who has a very specific reaction to the methylated B vitamins, they probably need two things. Number one, they need to make sure that their glycine levels are middle of the range normal. And number two, they need to start with very low doses and equilibrate to those very low doses and then titrate up very slowly over time. Now, as to whether I can speculate anything about pain or central sensitization of pain, I'm not sure. Just to throw out some random, I can't offer an answer to that. It's possible if I spent more time thinking about it, I could. But just to throw out some random threads that may or may not be of use, I think methylation in some people is going to lead to increased synthesis of dopamine, but in general, the effect is going to be to decrease the tonic pool of dopamine. There's going to be some degree to which it decreases other neurotransmitters. And it's possible that particularly if glycine is not stabilized, that you're going to lose the inhibitory effect of glycine, and that you might also lose the effect of ambient glycine in coactivating NMDA receptors. Now, off the top of my head, I would think that you would want the glycine there to support, I would think that if you lost glycine, that I would think that NMDA receptor hypofunction would not lead to central sensitization of pain. But I think in general, glutamate neurotransmission is going to promote chronic pain, and generally NMDA receptors are going to promote maybe not as much the pain itself as long-term potentiation and strengthening of synaptic connections that solidify the sensitization, but to the extent that glycine is a inhibitory neurotransmitter at many nerves where glutamate transmission could be involved in the pain, then I think it's possible that glycine depletion could play a role in why those methylated metabolites would lead to more of that pain neurotransmission that results in pain. And that would fit in with what I was saying before, which is my default base case is to assume that there's instability in the methylation flux that is driven in part by low glycine levels. And so I guess I would look there first as a possible explanation. But I'm speculating. All right. Thank you, Heather, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A from members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.